Hi guys, welcome back. If you are interested in running Android apps on your Windows 11 PC, you are in the right place. Android is a mobile OS based on Linux. And while most apps are designed for smartphones and tablets, today I will show you how to run Android directly on your PC using VirtualBox. So it's very simple, free method that lets you enjoy Android without an emulator. So let's get started. Before we begin, let's go over what you will need for this. A Windows 11 PC, VirtualBox installed, Android x86 ISO file, at least 2GB of RAM, and at least 20GB of free disk space. Before you dive into settings up VirtualBox, the first things you will need is the Android x86 ISO file. So for that, open your web browser and go to the official Android x86 websites. So this is the websites, the link I have given in the description below. Okay, so once you are on the site, now you need to click on the download link to access the latest stable releases. And here you will find main download site and other mirror site from where you can download. Okay, so it will always best to download from the main site. So click on this. And here in the left side, you will get download latest version. As of now, the latest stable release is listed Android 9.0 R2. So click on this and your download start. The file size will be around 950 MB, you can see. So make sure you have enough bandwidth and storage. And it might take few minutes to download that file, okay? So once the download start, choose a location on your PC where you can easily access the ISO file later. After that, you need to download and install VirtualBox. If you have not installed VirtualBox yet, make sure you do that first. You can download it from the official website. The link is in the description below. And you can also follow the installation procedure from my earlier video, which is also linked in the descriptions. So once you have done that, come back to this video and we will continue. Then open VirtualBox on your Windows 11 PC. You should see the VirtualBox manager. So click on the new button at the top. And here you need to give your virtual machine a name. So I am going to name it Android OS. For the type, you need to select Linux from the list. And for a version, select other Linux 64-bit. And after that, click on Next. Now set the memory size for the Android VirtualBox. To run the VirtualBox Android smoothly, at least 2GB memory size is recommended. Okay, so if you have plenty, you can go with 4GB. And in the same way, increase the processor count to a minimum of 2. And here I'm going to make it 3. Then click the next button. Now, the next step, choose create a virtual hard disk now. And if you want, you can make it 50GB, otherwise 20GB is okay. Then click on next. Here you can review the settings for your virtual machine. And after that, click finish to create the VM. Now in the left pane, you will see your Android OS should be ready. And before starting the virtual machine, you need to click on settings to tweak a few more options. Okay, so once you click on the settings, now come to the display tab. And here you need to increase the video memory to 128 MB. And then in graphics controller, change VM SVGA to VBox VGA. You can enable 3D acceleration if available. Now go to storage. And in the storage device section, click on the empty DVD icon. And then in the optical drive section, click on the CD icon. Then you need to click on choose a disk file. Here you need to browse the Android ISO file that you have downloaded earlier, so that you can install Android on VirtualBox from ISO file easily. Finally, press OK to save your virtual machine settings. and it will return to the main window. With everything set up, it's time to start the VM and install Android OS. For that, you need to click on the Start button. When the virtual machine starts, you will see the Android x86 installation menu. You need to use the arrow key on your keyboard to select Install Android x86 onto hard disk and press Enter. If all is okay, you will be asked to select a partition to install Android x86. Please choose Create Modified Partition and then choose the OK button and press Enter. When it asks you whether to use GPT, you need to select No and press Enter. On the new window, enter on New. Then again enter on Primary. It will tell you the size needed. Then press Enter again to confirm the size. Now you need to select Bootable and press Enter. When you see boot appears under the flag tab, now you can select right and press enter on it. Then type yes and press enter to confirm that you want to write the partition table to disk. Once the process is completed, you need to select quit and press enter. Now, you need to select the partition you just created to install Android x86. Here, you need to select a file system to format the partition. You can select anyone. So, I am going to select ext4 and press Enter. Now, choose Yes to confirm the format operation. After the format process is completed, choose Yes again to confirm that you want to install bootloader grub. Then select Yes to install system directory as read/write. Okay. So now the installation process will begin. It may take a few minutes to complete. After the installation process is completed, you will see that message says Android x86 is installed successfully. Then you need to select Run Android x86 and press Enter to boot into it. Now wait until you get the GUI and the Android logo appears. Once you see it, follow the on-screen instruction to complete the setup procedure. After that, you will be able to use the Android features right on your Windows 11 PC. So that's it for today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more tech tutorials. Thanks for watching.